That's right, brothers and sisters, you are tuned in to the Basement Tape Show. This is Nick Thomas along with Bootsy Hambone. This is show number 260 tonight, and we are creeping up onto the Halloween hour.
Oh, I like the way you said that. Creeping up.
But we are, you know, everybody loves Halloween. And but, you know, this is a show that takes you on a journey around the world. And we find the best musicians and best indie bands that's out there ever. And we got them right here for you tonight on The Basement. We're going to jump right into the music pretty quick here tonight. We do want to remind everybody, we're brought to you by Merle's Music.
Merle.
One of the coolest little music stores in the whole world. I'm not kidding. Go on down there. Walk in the door and tell them Bootsy sent you. They're going to take care of you. We're going to start the show out tonight with a band from out of Westchester, Pennsylvania, called Badger Static. I don't know what that means, but...
it's a cool name.
Yes, it is. And the name of the song is Never Been to Nashville. After that, the Sunday Reeds from out of Melbourne, Australia, doing a tune called Pretty People, and then... How do you say that?
It's Jack, short for Jacqueline.
Jacqueline. Oh, J-A-Q. Mackenzie from out of Los Angeles, California, doing a tune called I Tell You. Sit back, relax. You're in the basement with Nick and Bootsy tonight. It's going to be a great night. Get ready. This is Badger Static doing Never Been to Nashville.
Just like back in the day, Pretty people. the telephone. Can't call me anymore. Hands up and I'll take the blow. Forget all that said and done. You should just let me go. I tell you, can't mind the big broken situation. I tell you, I can't see this your destination. I tell you, can't mind the big broken situation. I tell you, tainted rose, shattered pride, makes you hide all your emotions and fears locked up inside. Hold me close, hold me tight, treat me right, screaming so loud I can barely put up a fight. I tell you, can't mind a very broken situation. I tell you, I can't see this from destination. I tell you, can't mind a very broken situation. I tell you,
hang up the telephone.
Oh, yeah, and that was Jack McKenzie doing a song called I Tell You, and I believe she's only about 16 years old. Before that, we heard from the Sunday Reeds doing a song called Pretty People, and we kicked it all off tonight with a band called Badger Static doing a song called Never Been to Nashville. Good stuff.
Right here in the basement with Nick and Bootsy, man. We have got all kinds of things going on tonight. And actually, Nick and Bootsy were on the road this weekend. And
we had fun. It was great.
It was a musical weekend, I'll have to say that. We started out going to the Pink Floyd tribute thing up at Castleman Hall.
Classic Albums Live, right?
It was excellent. Yeah, they did the whole Dark Side of the Moon album. And Bob Krause was nice enough to provide us a little pizza before we went. And he had a raffle, and I actually won a Pink Floyd book in the raffle from Bob. So that was so cool. Tell us about what we did after that, Bootsy.
Oh, well, after that, we went to, well, we started out at the Public House. So we decided to go back there because our buddy Kenny, who is one heck of a drummer, was out there playing with a couple of guys we had on the show a while back. Their cousins, Bill and Phil Wood. And along with Kenny, they make up a trio, a jazz trio called Cuz. Oh, we could have sat there all night long and listened to those guys. So we went and hung out and just relaxed, put our feet up and closed our eyes and listened to some great jazz music. Phil is just, he's amazing. He plays that keyboard, plays the melody. Well, I don't know. Does jazz have a melody?
Well, he plays the lead melody with his right hand, and he plays the bass on the keyboard with his left hand.
Oh, man. Sounds like he's got a stand-up bass down there.
It does. And he actually, you know, you can program those keyboards to have just bass stuff in the left side, in the bass side of it, and then have the piano sound or organ sound on the right-hand side. And he's just amazing. I don't know how people do it or that. He is just so good.
Oh, he's good. Well, and Bill's no slouch on the trombone.
Oh, no, he's fantastic.
And, of course, dude. Kenny's always awesome.
Kenny, he cracks me up when he plays with Dennis Foster sometimes. They do that, what's that song?
I love bread and butter. I like toast and jam.
That's some good stuff, man. I don't know if you guys know that song, but you should check it out. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, I hope we didn't scare you away from it with our rendition.
And then, of course, did you tell them about seeing Hot Mess, too?
No, I hadn't gotten that far. I was still talking about Cuz when you walked
in. Oh, okay. All right. And then we walked across the street, and we went upstairs and saw a band called Hot Mess. Mike Terry, man, he was tearing up the stage up there. And this new band in town at Hot Mess, they're a cover band, but man, they can make it sound good too. They had everybody cooking up there, so it was a good weekend for Nick and Bootsy. We had a great time.
Yes, we did. We like it when we can get in all sorts of music and not have to like stay out till midnight to do it.
No, we did all that within a short amount of time and got back home in time just to sit down and play guitars ourselves. So
it was a fun night.
It was.
Thanks, Bob.
Yes, thank you, Bob. I'm reading that book right now, as a matter of fact.
That was so cool. How many times do you go to dinner with somebody and they bring the pizza and raffle something off, too?
That's amazing.
Hey, man, I want to go to dinner with Bob more often. We owe you, Bob.
Hey, this next set's going to start out with Sandy Carroll. This is a gal from out of Pickwick Dam, Tennessee, doing a cool song called A Bad Bee Movie. I've seen a lot of bad B-movies before, but this is a song about it, I guess. Sandy Carroll, and she's fantastic. You're going to like this. Then, next up, after that, Bootsy, you better tell us about this one.
Oh, about Rock Box Hammer?
No.
Time and Dog.
Yeah.
Okay, Time and Dog. This is our instrumental of the evening, and the name of the song is Rock Box Hammer. I have no clue. But this is our evening's instrumental.
And I guess they are, or he is, out of
he
the
is.
UK.
He is. Tom yeah. Dog is out of the UK.
Cool. And then a band called Careless Eaters from out of Tacoma, Washington, doing a tune called Shut Up and Drive. So sit back, relax, man. You are in the basement with Nick and Bootsy. Sandy Carroll doing Bad B Movie.
Thank you. You're listening to The Basement Tape Show with Nick and Bootsy. Enjoy.
This is Tim Bond.
This is Chris Case.
And we're with Nick and Bootsy and doing the Basement Tapes.
Shut up and drive.
Speaking of careless eaters.
That's us right here in the basement, man. We got pizza.
No, we're careful. We're careful eaters.
Yeah, there's pizza and wings flying all over the place. It's like a food fight from Animal House around here.
It's okay,
here.
Steve. We'll take care of it before you leave.
All right. Hey, that's some good stuff right there. Careless eaters right there doing Shut Up and Drive from out of Tacoma, Washington. Before that, Rocks Box Hammer was the name of the song. A band out of the UK, actually a dude out of the UK, Time and Dog. And then Sandy Carroll started out doing Bad B Movie. Man, good stuff right here in the basement. We want to put a shout out to all of our friends out there. You know, there's so many of you guys out there, great musicians and great people who listen to the show. Ron Benoit always has something to say nice about the Basement Tape Show. So we want to put a little shout out to Ron out there tonight too. Hope he's listening tonight. Next up, we've got The Strands. It's a band out of Santa Monica, California, doing a tune called Feeling It. After that, The Hollywood Kills is a band out of Nashville, Tennessee, doing a tune called I Don't Walk Straight. Sometimes we don't. And Anthony Gomes from out of St. Louis, Missouri. What a great blues man. Doing a tune he wrote called The Blues Ain't the Blues Anymore. Now, you got to listen to this one to figure it out. So sit back, relax. Bootsy is going to tell you all about it.
I am?
Yeah, I thought you were.
I thought I was going to play some music.
Well, let's do it. Here's The Strands doing Feeling It. Check it out.
Just think I was ready to admit I failed. And Mike.
Chris.
And we're broken sons of karma, and you're listening to the Basement Tapes Show
with Nick and Bootsy.
Yeah!
This is Jason.
And this is BC. And we're from Don't Mind Dying.
And you're listening to the Basement Tape Show with Nick and Bootsy.
92.9 FM.
Ow. Your daughters and sons. Every moment is precious, every second, every day. We ain't got no tomorrow, we ain't got yesterday. Oh, oh, oh. was no more. Oh no. I said, somebody have mercy. The blues ain't the blues no more.
Anthony Gomes right there, right out of St. Louis, Missouri, doing the blues ain't the blues no more. Man, if you get a chance to go see Anthony Gomes in concert,
I'd love it.
Do not pass it up, man. That would be a great concert to go see. Yeah, before that, the Hollywood Kills doing I Don't Walk Straight. I love that song, too.
That's pretty good stuff.
Man, good stuff. And the Strands started it out with Feeling It. From out of Santa Monica, California, right there. So, good stuff. This is the Basement Tape Show. We are bringing you guys the best independent music that the whole world has to offer. Because, you know what? Everybody is local to somewhere. And we like to bring it all to you guys.
And you know, you won't get it just here on little old K-Kid 92.9 FM in Rolla, Missouri.
Which is the best ever.
Yes, it is, but... for those of you who aren't hearing this now, like Nick likes to say.
I like to say, if you ain't hearing this
right now.
You're
not hearing this right
now. You can check us out on a bunch of different website radio stations, and Bootsy's going to tell you where.
You can check us out on demand after tomorrow when I get the podcast of this show posted on our website, which is thebasementtapeswithnickandbootsy.rocks. Also, if you're the type of person that enjoys listening to internet radio, well, you can tune in on Tuesdays at 9 p.m. Central, 10 p.m. Eastern to the Indie Authority. On Wednesdays, you can catch this same show at 6 p.m. Central, 7 p.m. Eastern on Granite Coast Roots and Blues. And if you like listening at work, you can catch us on Thursdays at 11 a.m. Central, noon Eastern on Powers On Radio. So we got you covered just about all week long.
And you can just go to the website, and Bootsy's got a player there, and you can listen all day long to all of the shows or all of the tunes we played on
the last three
shows.
Yep.
Yeah, so it's all good right there in the basement. And that's the www.thebasementtapeswithnickandbootsy.com or .rocks.
That rocks.
And it's Bootsy is Bootsy. So that's Bootsy Hambone. She is a killer bass player, too. Did I mention that yet? And she's got a chick band, too, right now, and it's really getting popular.
Oh, we're having so much fun.
Her chick band is called Caboodle, and then right now it consists of, well, I'll let you tell everybody about it.
The name Caboodle came from Kathy Williams. That's where we get the C-A, and of course we get the boot from me. And we get the apostrophe L from Laura Co-Gwen. And we have been rehearsing here just recently with a chick drummer, Miss Erin Kane, who used to be the drummer for Medora. She's done some drumming with Nathan Matlock, and we're reining her in a little bit and say, hey, Erin, you want to do some acoustic stuff? And we're having a big time, and I think she is, too.
Well, that's all good. Check them out if you get to see Caboodle in concert. I'm sure they're going to be scheduling some stuff in the near future. Right now, we're going to get back into the music. Oh, great indie music here on the Basement Tape Show. Con Man Economy from out of Kirksville, Missouri, going to do a tune for you called Fall Back to Me. After that, Sloth Baby and the Land Pirates. They are out
my
of
my favorite band name of the week.
I'm not kidding. Out of Morrisontown, New Jersey, they're going to do a tune for you called Lincoln Built His Own House Before He Was Born.
And I have no clue where they got that title. When you listen to this song, if you can figure out where they got that title, let us know.
And then we're going to wrap it up with Exit 380. Doing a tune for you called Take It Like a Man. It's they're from out of the DFW area in Texas. So sit back, relax. You are in the basement with Nick and Bootsy. Turn this stuff up. It's going to be good. Con Man Economy. We'll be right back.
Hey, this is Ted from XAD, and you're listening to one of my favorite shows, The Basement Tapes with Nick and Bootsy.
This is Jack
and Lexi
with Dead Bed Bad,
and you're listening to the Basement Tape Show with Nick and Bootsy.
Can't clean it open, I can't.
Oh my gosh. Did you hear that? Exit 380 doing Take It Like a Man out of Dallas-Fort Worth, Texas area right there. Then before that, the Sloth Baby and the Lamb Pirates. Holy moly. Was that a cool Halloween song or what?
Did you ever hear anything in that song about Lincoln? The closest that I could get to Lincoln was there was a line in there about assassins.
That's probably just it.
And hey, lots of people have been assassinated, not just Lincoln. And what's that got to do with him building his own house before he was born?
I don't know. All I heard over was the chorus, you know, about I got too high and couldn't find my way down.
Hey, it worked out. If you've got a band called Sloth Baby and the Land Pirates, that's pretty much what you should expect.
I guess so.
I loved it.
Okay. Hey, it's time for birthdays right now, and we've got a few birthdays to mention.
We forgot to mention Con Man Economy started that set off.
Well, that's right. They did. It's good stuff right there.
Andrew and John.
Yeah, good stuff.
Right we'll have there. Pizza for you next time you're here. Anthony, not Andrew. I said Andrew, didn't I?
Yeah, you did.
Bootsy. I meant Anthony.
Bootsy, Bootsy, Bootsy.
Anthony.
Let's get into the birthdays real quick right now, because we have a very special birthday this week. Actually, it is his birthday today. Mr. Preston Rogers, the bass player extraordinaire from the Many Colored Death band out of Columbia, Missouri.
He's 26th.
My gosh.
I ran into his mama, Vicky. Yeah. I ran into her at the movie store the other night.
Yes.
And she told me he was going to be 26.
Well, he's like the bass player in Columbia.
He's a bass warrior.
He's one of the most amazing bass players I've ever seen. He stacks right up there close to Geddy Lee from Rush, no doubt about it.
Such a nice guy, too.
Yeah, super, super, super stuff. And let's see, who else do we have birthdays for this week? Trina Burns, happy birthday to Trina. Linda Plank, happy birthday this week. Samuel J. Stone, happy birthday to Samuel this week. Charlene Muma, happy birthday to Charlene.
Yay,
this
Charlene.
Week.
We saw Charlene
she
last
is so
night.
Cool. Yeah, what a sweetheart there. Neil Farrar, it's his birthday this week. Happy birthday. Dan Schramm, happy birthday this week. Jillian Risco. Risco? Yeah, okay.
Of Red Velvet Crush.
That's right. What a fantastic musician. Ron Benoit's having a birthday. We did a shout out to Ron earlier this week.
Yay, Ron.
On the show. Happy birthday to Ron this week. Sherry Kyle, happy birthday to Sherry this week. Sarah Guerrero, happy birthday. Josh Meyer, happy birthday. Doug Holt, happy birthday. And Phil Bathockery is having a birthday
Phil.
This week. Rock on, brother. You just keep on going. I know you will. Who do you have, Bootsy?
Well, it's Brenda Gill's birthday this week. It's also Patty Donnell's, Jennifer Yoder's, and Leslie Wilson.
No kidding.
Yeah,
happy
it's
birthday,
Leslie's
Leslie.
Birthday this week. And Tom Juno.
Happy birthday to Tom this week, too. And if you're having a birthday this week and we didn't happen to mention your name, you know, always a big happy birthday from the Basement Tape Show, because you know what we always say? Keep singing the blues because they feel so good. Happy birthday, you guys.
Happy birthday to you.
Ow!
Happy birthday to you.
Yeah, you in the front row.
Happy birthday.
All the Kiss fans in the world.
Happy birthday to you.
Come on, everybody!
Woo! That was awesome.
Thank you, Paul. Thanks for coming in.
You're very welcome.
Here's your $10 and your pack of Marlboro.
All right!
One of the best.
And that was the Many Colored Death.
That was the Many Colored Death.
Happy birthday for
yes,
you guys.
Yes, and Brent Moore, God love him, was struggling with allergies and a bad cold and everything, and he still did a pretty good Paul Stanley.
That's pretty good right there. We are having a great time in the basement tonight, and Nick's Picks is going to take you out of the universe tonight.
You think?
Well, it's some good stuff. I picked out the Smith Brothers. If you don't know the Smith Brothers, they are a band. They are the Bad Boys from Boston. Aerosmith, I'm talking about. And I've got some good stuff lined up for you. Dusty from my living room chair show would be proud of me for picking this stuff out, because it's not very often you get to hear a rock band like Aerosmith do a jam band set. I'm going to start out Nick's picks with Aerosmith doing a tune called Moving Out. It's one of my favorite songs off their self-titled album, Aerosmith, from 1973. I love it because I know how to play it on a guitar. Yeah. And it's a lot of fun to play on the guitar, too. If you don't know it, you can figure it out pretty easy. It's pretty cool. And then after that, I'm going to play a couple of tunes that go back-to-back on their 1978 live bootleg album. This is live stuff. And it's recorded, actually, these two songs were recorded live in Paul's Mall in Boston, Massachusetts in April of 1973 as well. And it's going to be I Ain't Got You, and it's going to go into Mother Popcorn. My buddy AJ used to just love these tunes back in the old days. We'd listen to them on turntables back then. So this is Nick's picks. Aerosmith, the Smith Brothers, the Bad Boys from Boston doing Moving Out.
All night, Dwight. Got a 56 Cadillac with a spare tire on the back. Got a charge counting on that. Say that I ain't got no. We got a classic in a pool and a big hair ghoul. No matter what I do, say that.
Mother for me. Hey! sister, so listen here. I just don't know what went wrong. Had dove and lover, I sing a simple song. I told myself, see, well, you got to have a mom for me. Well, you gotta have a mother for me. See? Well, you gotta have a mother for me. Let's get out of here. See? Well, you gotta have a mother for me. They gotta have a mother for me. They gotta have a mother for me. Say, I gotta have a mama, say, I gotta have a mama, say, I'll help! 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 You gotta have mama for me. Thank you. The King. Something by the King. We know the King.
No, man. Aerosmith. The Smith Brothers right there. The Bad Boys from Boston. Doing a little Mother Popcorn. What? That you don't get to hear this stuff anywhere else but the Basement Tape Show with Nick and Bootsy. That's what it's all about right here. We're brought to you by Merle's Music, by the way. Merle's Music is one of the coolest little music stores that you will ever find. They've got a great selection of guitars and basses, PAs, amps, you name it. They've got it. They give lessons for almost anything down there. You go down there and ask them if they can teach you how to play something. They'll probably find somebody that'll help you if they don't already offer it. And every week they do a little riff of the week. And last week it was a really cool one, Ziggy Stardust by David Bowie. If you're just an inspiring guitar player and you want to learn really cool riffs, go to Merle's Music Facebook and look for all of the different riffs of the week on there, because it's all good. Jason's going to teach you some stuff. Who's the other guy from
Matt Van Kirk.
Uh huh. And he's, what band is he with?
Cricket Alley.
Of course, Cricket Alley. What a great band right there.
Travis Hutchins is not any slouch on the bass either.
Absolutely not. And you can check out all of the riff of the week on Merle's Music right there on the Facebook. And it's good. This week, it goes really good this week with the concert that we just saw at Castleman Hall, the Pink Floyd tribute band right there, or classic rock albums
they do,
band.
They do the Eagles.
They do a lot of stuff.
They do other Pink Floyd. They do Led Zeppelin. They do lots of classic albums.
But they were really good on the Pink Floyd one the other night.
Mm-hmm.
And we actually, Bootsy and I got there, and we sat down. It was a little early in the show, and there was a mother-daughter sitting right next to us, and I'm sorry I can't remember their names. I wish I could, but I want to put a big shout-out to them. They were so cool, the young daughter, she was trying to soak this all in because we were speaking with her mom about how cool Pink Floyd was in the early days and stuff, and it was really fun to visit with them. And I hope they're listening tonight, because tonight's riff of the week by Merle's Music is Brain Damage off of the Pink Floyd album Dark Side of the Moon. And so all you have to do is go to Merle's Music Facebook and watch Jason show you how to play this. I want to tell it to the young girl that we saw the other night, because her mom says she's an inspiring guitar player.
Yeah, she's working
so
on it.
She needs to go to Merle's Music Facebook and check out the way that Jason shows you how to play Brain Damage off of Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon. He does event. He's a great teacher. He's a really good guitar teacher, and you can learn all this stuff just by watching the video.
You know what I was thinking? It's really cool too that Merle's Music does have their own YouTube channel. And all of these different riffs of the week that they've been doing, those are all going on to Merle's YouTube channel. So you can go and you can learn how to do all the riffs that they've done so far. So they're building up a pretty good collection.
Yeah, it's really cool. But we've decided we're going to go ahead and play.
Well, I have something else to tell you about Merle's before we do.
Well, you just go right ahead, Bootsy.
You know, something else that Merle does, and he does it several times a year, is he invites other musicians or musicians into the store to give lessons and cool stuff like that. And he's got a couple of them coming up in October. On the 22nd, he's got Richard Gilowitz. I think that's how you say that. He's going to be doing two different workshops. He's going to be doing a guitar workshop at 4 p.m. on the 22nd. And at 5 p.m., get your ukulele out and take it to Merle's, because he's going to be doing a ukulele workshop.
Really? Who's going to be doing that workshop?
Richard Gilowitz.
All right.
And on the 28th, Merle does this every year, and it's about that time again. It's time for the Taylor Road Show.
I love
Merle's
that.
Music.
That is very interesting. They have a great guitar player come in from Taylor and play some fantastic stuff.
They just blow you
away every time.
You really need to get that riff of the week posted on Merle's Facebook page and get your name in there for that 15% off, because you might need a new ukulele or a new Taylor, and that 15% off really help you out on that Taylor.
No doubt about that.
Those are pricey.
But they're good guitars, man. Top of the line right there. That's Merle's music, and this is the riff of the week song. This is Brain Damage by Pink Floyd.
On the grass, remembering games and daisy chains and laughs. Got to keep the loners on the path. The lunatic is in the hall. The lunatics are in my home. The paper holds their folded faces to the floor, and every day the paper boy brings more.
I'll see you on the dark side.
All right, that was Merle's Riff of the Week song right there, Brain Damage by Pink Floyd off of Dark Side of the Moon. That was a very fun concert to go to the other night at Castleman Hall. It was very entertaining. Good people, good fun right there. Right now, we're going to get right back into the indie music for you guys, though. I kind of feel like we left it for a little bit right there. Of course we did, but back to St. Louis, Missouri. Post-Nuclear Trash, a great band out of St. Louis, doing a tune for you guys tonight called Still Hitting the One. After that, another band out of St. Louis, Missouri, Cluster Pluck, doing a tune called Mortar and Rocks. And then after that, out of Victoria, British Columbia, Canada, the Ball, Gag, and Chain Gang, doing a tune called Three Jacks.
I like that laughter and that Pink Floyd thing.
That's some pretty cool stuff, wasn't it?
Yeah, the people that were with Classic Albums Live did a pretty good job, I thought. I thought the girl that they had doing the female part, I thought she was really good.
She did. She did a fantastic job. Yeah. Yeah, I'd go see him again.
Oh, I thought.
But I'd like to see him do something different, too.
I'd like to see him do a different album. They do several classic albums, not just that one. I'd like to see him do Led Zeppelin.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. They've got a number of them, too. So, but
I think
they
do an Eagles album, too.
I'd like to see the Eagles album, to tell you the truth. Like the best of. Hey, sit back, relax, though. This is the best of the indie music all around the world, especially St. Louis, Missouri, right here. This is Post-Nuclear Trash doing Still Hitting the One.
Hey, this is Joe from For the Broken, and you're listening to Nick and Bootsy from the Basement Tapes. Rock!
Hey, crossroads, my bed, a hard place to lay my head. Your song, so sweet, we just need to rest these feet. 3 days and I'm gone, hopefully it won't be long. This kiss is goodbye.
This is John Galbraith from John Galbraith and the Broken Promises, and you're listening to The Basement Tape Show with Nick and Bootsy.
Yeah.
All right, that was Ball Gag and Chain Gang doing Three Jacks out of Victoria, British Columbia, Canada right there.
You know what I wonder? You know, we were talking about that had kind of a Quentin Tarantino sound to it.
It did, yeah.
Pulp Fiction, you know, the guy that they kept in the box.
Oh, yeah,
with the ball and the gag and the chains on it.
Oh,
what if they got their name from that movie?
I was wondering that. You know, that movie, Pulp Fiction, it sparked all kinds of ideas.
That was a weird movie, but I could, like, watch it over and over again.
You bet. And, of course, that type of music just goes along with Quentin Tarantino movies well. You know, good stuff right there. Cluck before that.
Clusterpuck.
Puck. Okay. Mortar and Rocks before that, and then Post Nuclear Trash started it out. Both of those out of St. Louis, Missouri, doing all kinds of good music. Right here in the basement with Nick and Bootsy. We have a special guest in the studio right now.
It's apostrophe L from Caboodle.
Laura, how is she doing tonight?
Laura, are you hiding from us in there?
I think she might have just went back to the back there for a second.
I think she might have.
Yeah, that's okay. Anyway, let me think. We've got a couple more tunes lined up for you guys tonight to call it a night. But we want to remind everybody, don't forget the guys in the morning show. Stan, Steve, and Jesse doing the morning show all week long here on K-Kid. They've got the backwards song of the day. They're always giving away some really cool stuff. They got contests going all the time. It is good stuff right here on K-Kid in the morning, every Monday through Friday on the morning show. And then the Living Room Chair Show. We can't say enough good things about our friend Dusty on the Living Room Chair Show. He plays the coolest jam band music that you will ever hear. He's out there left to right, up to down. You don't know what he's going to play next, but it's all good jam band music right there on the Living Room Chair Show every Saturday night, every Saturday afternoon, starting at 3 o'clock, and then he just keeps playing music until he wears out, and he calls it a night. But check that out as well. We've got a couple more tunes for you guys right now. It's Snarky Dave and the Prickly Bluesmen from out of Townsend, Delaware.
My second favorite band name of the night.
That is a good...
Snark.
Snarky Dave and the Prickly Bluesmen.
She's there.
Yeah. Here's Laura. Yeah, Laura is
here. It's apostrophe L.
From the Caboodle.
Come say hello.
It's the guitarist and mandolin player from Caboodle.
Songbird.
Of course. She does write her own material, too. Laura, how you doing tonight?
Oh, I'm doing great. It's wonderful to be here. I was in town, thought I'd stop by and say hello to you and all your wonderful listeners. It's a great show.
Thank you.
Thank you. It's good to see you tonight. Yeah. And I guess LeVan and Rick were playing out at the Tater Patch tonight, having a good time out there.
That is correct. Nice crowd out there. Delicious food, as always, at the Tater Patch.
Yum, yum.
Had a great time.
All right. So we always like having visitors here in the basement with Nick and Bootsy. This is Snarky Dave and the Prickly Bluesmen doing a little tune called Makes No Sense.
Oh, thief. No one does their job right. Gotta watch out what you eat. It makes no sense. What's going on? I don't know. What's the truth? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. Now I can't find Johnny's grave. We're all pointing fingers, and nothing's getting saved. It makes no sense. It makes no sense. It makes no sense. Truth. I don't know, I don't know, I don't know. It makes no sense. It makes no sense. It makes no sense. What's going on? I don't know. What could be the truth?
Hey man, I got an idea. Let's go down to the basement. What's in the basement? I don't know. Let's go find out.
What's in the basement?
I don't know. Let's go find out.
The basement.
Right, it's Nick and Bootsy on the Basement Tape Show, silly. Thank you.
this morning. And my baby was gone. Yes, I woke up this morning. And my baby was gone. Well, I just sat down and got me a pencil and paper. You know I wrote down this song. I got to come back home, baby blue. She told me she loved me. And you know she said that she'd never leave. I just can't understand.